We have seen how to use built-in permissions and how to do some basic authorization with an admin controller. What we'll do now is that we'll create our first own custom permission. So it will be a permission like the built-in ones. We will be able to authorize against it, but we will define it ourselves and we'll see how it integrates with the rest of the system. So let's go back to our module. And in our module, let's actually add a permission, because how you define permissions is in so-called permission providers. And that's a common pattern in Orchard. We have seen that you can extend Orchard and hook into Orchard's events by implementing interfaces. With permission providers, the idea is the same. You implement an interface and Orchard will pick it up and integrate it with the rest of the system. The namespace where we commonly put permission providers is in permissions. So what I will create now is will be a small permission provider to manage person pages. So it will be just a small demonstration to give you a quick idea. And under permissions, let's also create our person page permissions. Now, the idea here is to provide a permission that represents your ability to do something with person pages, which is just a simple example, but don't take it wrong. Permissions don't have to be tied to content items or to actions related to content items. You can create a permission for whatever you like. You just have to define it in a permission provider. And probably you already thought about it, but we have a snippet for permission providers as well, so we don't have to write everything by hand. So first we need a class for permission providers, of course, which needs to derive from IPermissionProvider. And then in there, we have to define the permissions themselves. And these need to be objects of the class permission. So let's call this permission something like manage person pages. Looks right. And permissions also need to have some kind of description. Remember that under the role editor page, you can see a list of permissions. Now all the human readable text you see there is, well, the descriptions defined in these permissions. So can do something like can manage person pages. That's not too much information, but for now it will be sufficient. And then what you need to do in such a permission provider, this will be enough from the snippet, is that the permission provider needs to return the permissions, because here it is such a static field that contains this permission object, but Orchard can't really read it yet. This get permissions async method is to return all the permission objects in this permission provider. And then in get default stereotypes, you can return all the default configuration of those permissions corresponding to specific roles. So a common thing is that the administrator role, or I would say the name called administrator, because this is a convention, the administrator role should have all the permissions, hence why it's an administrator. And here what you can see is an example of returning a stereotype for the administrator role. You can see that here we are basically telling Orchard that the administrator role should by default possess this permission. And this is a collection, as you can return, of course, multiple permissions here. Multiple permissions for a specific role, because this is a permission provider, it can contain any number of permissions. And secondly, you can return these default configuration for any number of roles. So here we could also define that the contributor role needs to have this permission by default too. this is just the default. You can change this from the admin UI, of course. And a permission provider is a dependency, so we need to register it here in the startup class still. So I will just do that. It's a scoped registration. It needs to be registered for IPermissionProvider, and then what we register is person page permissions. All right. So far, so good. Now we have defined the permission, but we didn't yet authorize against it. So before starting the application, let's quickly check it. And we had the person controller where we retrieved all the person pages. I wouldn't go back to that because we still won't need to do all the stuff we started here. The admin controller will be a simple example again. And what we can do is that we can continue with this content authorization action, and also check the authorization status of this permission, but still authorize against this person page. That's, by the way, not necessary. And actually, in this case, it wouldn't be good either, because our permission is not really tied to a content item. We could also do that, but you can just create generic permissions. A user either has that, and then they can do something or not. Not every permission needs to be tied to any particular entity anywhere. It can be just general, you either have it or not. So let's actually not continue with that, but let's continue with a different action here. And let's call it custom authorization instead of content authorization. We won't need a person page here, nor we will need to authorize against it. And we will need to use our person page permissions instead and manage person pages. And that's it. It's still authorize async. It's still authorization for a specific user against this permission. And again, as I said previously, always authorize against permissions. Don't just check roles. That might seem tempting, but it's very crude. Role names can change. It can change which permissions each role should have. That's not a good thing. If you have a permission that's very clear, you can provide that allow that permission in multiple roles. Very clear, very straightforward. All right, so let's open our controller here again. We will need to open /admin. Let me copy the module name first. We'll need to open /admin, /dojocourse.module, and /admin again, and custom authorization. And it's false. Why is it false? Well, shouldn't the admin user have the permission? Well, let's check it out. We are not logged in with the admin user, so that's the issue. Still with the restricted user we have seen from the last session. So let's go and log in with the admin user instead. Admin password 1! Still. And now, once we have done that, we can check this permission again, and now we are authorized. So that's good, but just to make sure, let's go to the roles configuration pages, and let's check out how our permission here looks like. So it's called can manage person pages. As you can see, it actually shows up. It's not ticked, but since it's enabled by default, we under effective, we see here that the administrator role actually has it. And you see, here's the pattern that we have seen for other modules. First, we see the module, the features ID here. And if we search like this, we see it in the context of the list. So here we have the section for our module, for our feature. And here we have listed all the permissions our feature has. If the permission provider would have multiple permissions, those would be listed here as well. And of course, you can also have multiple permission providers in all of your features of your module. So this is how you define custom permissions, and this is how you authorize against custom permissions. Permissions are just permissions. So just as I said multiple times before, Orchid is very extensible and very flexible. And one of the reasons for that is that modules are just modules. Content permissions, the built-in common permissions, just work in the same way as the permissions that you define in your modules, because it's the same. There is no cheating, no special treatment for built-in modules. Built-in modules are modules like your modules. So this can be very useful when building a more complex system where you need to have fine-grained access control. You can put such authorization checks, and I actually encourage you to put a lot of such authorization checks into every place where a user interaction starts. Always make sure that your users are actually allowed to do what you allow them to do with that specific feature.